Hi YouTube, DFishman76 here. Bees in a barrel. That's what we're messing with today. This barrel come out of the woods right here. Can't really see it, and I didn't really record it because there was really no way to do it. So brought the barrel out here. We're gonna put it in this hive equipment. The homeowner actually wants to keep these bees, so we're gonna put them in a box for him. So stick around. This should be a fun one. We're gonna crank up the side grinder and open this barrel up. Hope I have enough battery life on my camera, and we'll see what happens. Time they were.
See, all this over here is all new cone. Mm-hmm. This all right here is stuff a little bit. The whole thing right there. Yep. That's how it's doing right here. It's really down there. He sells queens, he sells.
Yeah, he sells a little bit of everything down there. If they're queenless, they're
often docile to be queenless. Normally queenless have. They're more aggressive and stuff.
Well, we got through with that barrel cut out. Once I opened up the barrel itself and looked in the hive, it was queenless. Kind of hate when that happens or whatever, but sometimes you don't really know what's going on with it. So all we can do is I cut out all the brood comb, the old brood comb. There was no brood or anything else, and they had very little honey storage. The wax moths and the hive beetles were actually starting to move in to the hive, so it was destined it would be dead in just a few more weeks, and the hive beetles and the wax moths would have destroyed it. So what I did was I cut the old brood comb out. Most of the time, if your wax moths are going to destroy something, that's what you're going to get. The fresh wax that's still never been had any brood or anything else, and most of the time they'll leave it alone. So that's what I did. I just cut out all the old comb, left some of the new stuff. We put the barrel back together and put it back where it was at. So hopefully most of those bees will gravitate back to the barrel, but it's going to be for nothing because they're going to end up dying. So you kind of hate to see that happen, but that's just the way it is. They had plenty of queen cells they had made up, but it was a little bit too little too late is what I like to call that. There was probably 15 or 20 queen cells in there, which some people would call them emergency cells, but there was no eggs or larvae or anything else in them. So that was the end of that one. I don't know how much of the video I'm going to be able to use, but I just wanted to tell y'all how it ended up. Everybody's doing good. Until the next one.